Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. How are you today, everyone? It's nice to see you again with me in paragraph writing class. And today's lessons, we are going to talk about paragraph unity and coherence. Okay, why do you need to learn about paragraph unity and coherence? Because hopefully in the end of this class, you are able to apply paragraph unity theory in writing a paragraph, and you are able to apply paragraph coherence theory in writing a paragraph, and also you are able to identify paragraph unity and coherence theory in a paragraph. Before we start to learn about unity and coherence itself, you need to know what is paragraph. Paragraph, it's a group of sentences organized around one central topic. Remember, only one central topic. In previous meeting, we have learned about how to create a good topic sentence. And now we are going to learn how to make a paragraph becomes unity and also coherence. The sentences in this paragraph should follow one clear path through the topic. All those sentences should be connected one to each other. And how to make it into a good paragraph, unity and coherence, at least we need to use four elements to create unified paragraph that do not wander around. What are those elements? The four elements are, the first is unity, second is order, third is coherence, and fourth is completeness. And we are going to discuss it one by one. The element number one is unity. Start with the topic sentence. Do you still remember about hamburger theory that we have learned previously? Every other sentence support this one idea with informations that point back to it or explain it. It here refers to topic sentence. The paragraph is unified around that one idea. So we can call it a paragraph unity if the sentences support one topic sentence. For example, like this one. Sunday is my favorite day because I can watch football with my dad, and there are other sports on the other days to watch on televisions. As we can see here, the topic sentence is Sunday is my favorite day because I can watch football with my dad. But look at the second sentence. There are other sports on other days to watch on televisions. The second sentence here doesn't have any connections or doesn't support the first sentence, which is topic sentence. How watching football with dad makes Sunday your favorite day is topic sentence, and we need to talk about football and Sunday as my favorite day, then talk about other sports. So we are going to focus on the football itself. Do you understand, everyone? Okay. Now, what do you need to do to make the paragraph unity is do not include unrelated details here. Sentences like this do not relate to the main idea in the topic sentence. There are other sports on other days to watch on televisions. Or, some days my dad doesn't make it home from work until I'm in a bed. As you can see, those two previous sentences are not connected with the topic sentence, which is Sunday is my favorite day because I can watch football on televisions with my dad. Okay. Example of unity is like this one. Sunday is my favorite day because I can watch football with my dad. He spends the whole day watching football on televisions with me since he doesn't have to work that day. As you can see here, the second sentence elaborates on the main topic. So, this is unified start. How do you feel, everyone? Is that correct? Okay, do you have a questions? If you don't have any questions about unity, now we come to our second element, which is order. You can order your supporting sentences in different ways. There are three ways to make your paragraph in order. Number one is by chronology. By chronology means the order of events in time. Number two is by importance, the order of most to least important, or least to the most important. The next one is by logic, the order that makes the most sense based on the topic. Okay, why is order important? Random sentences cause confusions. Without organizations of your sentences, it's hard to tell what your main idea is. Order helps you make your point and helps the reader follow along from one idea to the next one until you prove your conclusions. What is the order? What is the correct order of these sentences? Please listen carefully. I'm going to give you 5 sentences and I want you to make it into good order. Okay. A. And if I'm really late, I even miss the school bus. B. If I forget to set my alarm, I get up late and rush through everything. C. As a result, I often have to cook my breakfast. D. It's always much better if I remember to set the alarm so I have more time to get ready. And next, I also might rush out and forget my books. If you look or if you listen carefully from those 5 sentences, it's hard for us to get the idea or the order of the paragraph. That's why order is really important. So, what do you think the first sentence of a good paragraph in a good order? Yes, you are right. So, the first sentence is, if I forget to set my alarm, I get up late and rush through everything. That becomes topic sentence and the other sentences will support. For example, and if I'm really late, I even miss the school bus. The school bus here is the example. What will happen if I get up late? So, the first thing is, if I forget to set my alarm, I get up late and rush through everything. And the other sentences are supporting the topic sentence. When you have a good order of a paragraph, it will be easier for the reader to get the idea of your writing itself. Okay. Now, we come to our third element, which is coherence. This is how you make your writing understandable to the reader. You make your paragraph coherent by connecting ideas to one another. Okay, there are 2 ways of creating coherence in a paragraph. The first one is use transition words to create bridges from one sentence to the next. Second, be consistent in using flip tenses and a point of view. This coherence will make the paragraph work as a whole unit with everything working together. Now we are going to discuss type of transition words. Words that show order. For example, first, second, third. So for example, you are going to talk about your daily activity. You can support your topic sentence with words that show order. For example, first, what do you do in the morning? Second, what next? And third, and so on. The next one is word shows spatial relationship. For example, above, below, beside. For example, you are going to create an argumentative paragraph and you are going to show about spatial order. So you can use above, below, beside. And then the next thing is word shows logical order. For example, furthermore, in fact, in additions, and many more. However, those are not the only words. You can find it in another books or another sources, for example, Google. So you can find many examples of transition words. Okay. The next thing is verb tenses and point of view. So besides using word orders, you can also you need to also use verb tenses and point of view. Verb tenses here should all be consistently present tense. For example, if you are going to use present tense, or consistently past tense if you are going to talk about your past experience. Look at the example. Sunday used to be my favorite day because I could watch football with my dad. He spends the whole day watching football on television with me since he doesn't have to work that day. As you can see here, we have two kinds of tenses, past tense and also present tense. That's why this paragraph is not unified in tense because it uses two kinds of tense. You need to be consistent to use only present tense or past tense. Okay. Point of view. Write from the point of view of the same persons. For example, Sunday is his favorite day because he can watch football with his dad. I have lunch with my dad while we watch a game together. As you can see here, point of view changes from he or his to I or mine in the second sentence, and it is not good point of view. So if you are going to make it into the same point of view, you need to be consistent too. For example, Sunday is my favorite day because I can watch football with my dad. I have lunch with my dad while we watch a game together. Okay. The example previously has the same point of view. Have you understood, everyone? Okay. Now we come to our fourth element, which is completeness. For a complete paragraph, you need enough information to support the main idea or prove your thesis. If all sentences clearly and thoroughly support the main idea, the paragraph is complete. Main part of a complete paragraph should be, remember about Hamburger theory. The first one is topic sentence. The name is topic sentence, so it is in a form of sentence, and there should be topic or an interesting subject and its controlling idea, which will control the main idea itself. The second one is supporting sentences. Okay, usually at least we need to have three sentences to support our topic sentence or to develop the main idea thoroughly. Okay, the third is concluding sentence to summarize the main idea and reinforce the topic sentence. Okay, remember hamburger, topic sentence, supporting sentences, and also concluding sentence. That will make your paragraph becomes a complete paragraph. Now, I'm going to give you sample paragraph with all four elements that we have discussed before. Listen carefully. Sunday is my favorite day because I spend the day watching football with my dad. On Sunday, unlike the other days of the week when he works, my dad spends the whole day with me watching football on televisions. We even eat lunch together while watching. The highlight of the day is watching the Dolphins game. Dad and I get so excited. We yell and cheer together. On Sundays, I get to combine watching my favorite sport and spending time with my favorite persons. What a great day! Okay, so from the example here, as you can see, we have topic sentence. Sunday is my favorite day because I spend the day watching football with my dad. And also there are several sentences which are supporting the topic sentence. And we have also our concluding sentence here which reinforce the topic sentence itself. What do you think? Okay, I think today's lesson is enough. If you have questions, you may contact me via WhatsApp or email, and hopefully you can create a good paragraph with a good unity and coherence after learning these lessons. See you everyone, and wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.